Discuss the simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling in brief. We know that, on the basis of working, air refrigeration systems are of four types. Simple air refrigeration system, bootstrap air refrigeration system, regenerative air refrigeration system, and reduced ambient air refrigeration system. Also, simple air refrigeration system can be further classified into two parts, without evaporative cooling and with evaporative cooling. Now let's discuss the simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling in detail. A typical simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling can be shown as: it mainly consists of four parts. Main compressor, whose function is to compress the incoming air. Heat exchanger, whose function is to cool down the compressed air. Cooling turbine, whose function is to expand the cold compressed air to further decrease its temperature. And a cooling fan, whose function is to draw the cooling air through the heat exchanger. Now let's understand its working in detail. The fresh air at atmospheric pressure gets sucked into the diffuser, which slows it down, thereby reducing its velocity and converting its kinetic energy into pressure. Ideally, this ram compression is considered as isentropic in nature. This slightly compressed air is then further passed on to the main compressor, where it gets compressed to a higher pressure. The external work required by the compressor for this compression is provided by the gas turbine. In this process, the air gets heated. Ideally, this process is considered isentropic in nature. A small portion of this high-pressure heated air is bled off from the main compressor, whereas the rest of the air is sent to the combustion chamber. This bled-off air is sent to the heat exchanger, where it gets cooled down to a lower temperature by rejecting heat to the cooling air. This cooling air is obtained by bleeding off some portion of the air after ram compression. Ideally, this process is considered isobaric in nature. This cold compressed air is then sent to the cooling turbine, where it gets expanded to the cabin pressure, thereby reducing its temperature well below the cabin temperature. Ideally, this process is considered isentropic in nature. The work produced by this turbine is used to run the cooling fan, which draws the hot cooling air from the heat exchanger and expels it in atmosphere. This cool air is then sent to the cabin and cockpit, where it absorbs heat from the equipment and occupants and thereby provides cooling. Ideally, this process is considered as isobaric in nature. This heated air is then exhausted in atmosphere, thereby completing the cycle. Its TS diagram can be given as: here process 1-2S represents the isentropic compression, which takes place in the diffuser. Process 2S-3S represents the isentropic compression, which takes place in main compressor. Process 3S-4 represents the isobaric heat rejection, which takes place in the heat exchanger. Process 4-5S represents the isentropic expansion, which takes place in the cooling turbine. And process 5S6 represents the isobaric heat addition, which takes place in the cabin. Therefore, the cycle 1-2S-3S-4-5S6 constitutes the ideal simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling. Now we know that, in actual practice, no compression or expansion process is isentropic in nature due to the presence of internal friction and irreversibilities. Therefore, the actual TS diagram for simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling can be shown as: here process 1-2 represents the actual irreversible adiabatic compression taking place in diffuser. Process 2-3 represents the actual irreversible adiabatic compression taking place in main compressor. Process 3-4 represents the isobaric heat rejection, which takes place in the heat exchanger. Process 4-5 represents the actual irreversible adiabatic expansion, taking place in cooling turbine. And process 5-6 represents the isobaric heat addition, which takes place in the cabin. Therefore, the cycle 1-2-3-4-5-6 constitutes the actual simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling. Now let's summarize the simple air refrigeration system without evaporative cooling.